Loop tasks are an easy and powerful way of delegating work to each other, monitoring it, and executing it as a team. Only problem is, I want to know all the work which I've assigned to others. The solution is a workaround, which I'll explain in this video. You can add loop tasks in many different places. The most important and common is, of course, Teams meetings, but you can also add them to Teams chat, Teams channels, emails in Outlook, Word, OneNote, and even Whiteboard. So how do you add it? A loop component called task list. Each row is a task. You have the description of the task, who is supposed to do it, just at the rate mention, specify the deadline, and by default, the category is to do, category or bucket. You can add it as different buckets if you like. And then you can also change the view from table view to board view, something like a Kanban view. So that's it. This is how you delegate work. So now that we know tasks can be generated from so many different places, there are two things we need to monitor. One is, as a person, which are the tasks assigned to me? Just go to the To-Do app, go to the Assigned to Me section and look at the list. Tasks assigned to you from Loop, anywhere in Loop or in Planner or even in To-Do app itself automatically appear in this area. Coming to task assigned by me, there is no unified method available. So we will have to find a workaround. The workaround is go to Teams chat, search for your name, click on it, and now you can chat with yourself. Click on the three dots or ellipses and choose pin. That way you can find this chat easily right on top. My tasks are scattered all over the place. So let's say this is my group chat going on and I have a task list. Copy the link or say copy component, go to the self chat and paste it there. That's the extra work we have to do every time you create a loop task list, whether it is in chat or meeting or email, doesn't matter. When you copy paste it into self chat, you can see the live status. You can update it anywhere. It's going to update it everywhere. After copy paste, each task list is going to remain separate, but you just have a convenient single place to go to. One best practice is to give legible names as soon as you create a loop task list, so that when you see the consolidated list, there is no confusion. So try this out with your colleagues and your execution will become better. Of course, there are many other ways of task management. Have a look at this comprehensive video to understand more. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.